Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we're going to learn how to send mass emails and how to send list emails in Salesforce. We will show you the differences in how they both function and what you should be aware of and the limitations you may run into. Sending a mass email from Salesforce should not be used for emailing purchase lists or people you don't know. It is recommended for sending emails to groups of people who currently have a business relationship with you. Let's see how to use Salesforce to send these types of emails. Before we show you how to send a list email or mass email from Salesforce, we want to make sure that you understand what these features are meant for. You should not use these methods for emailing thousands of people from a purchase list that you do not have a business relationship with. List emails and mass emails are meant for sending emails to notify your customers of a business transaction, information that they need to know in order to be able to do business with you. Not promotional emails, letting them know you're going to be offering a new product or service. It is recommended that you use a marketing automation system like a Mailchimp, Marketing Cloud, Pardot, Campaign Monitor to handle these mass marketing email campaigns. These systems allow you to set up a dedicated IP address and a custom email domain for sending emails. This will protect your main company email domain from being blacklisted due to spam reports. We're also going to put some links down below to CAN-SPAM laws. You need to be aware of how they define a promotional email versus a transactional email so you can make the appropriate choice in how you're going to send out your emails so that you are not violating any laws. Violations of these laws can be pretty costly for your company. We're also going to make sure that you're aware of what your emails need to contain to be CAN-SPAM compliant. So make sure to check out all that information below before you start sending out any emails. All right, enough lecturing. Let's teach you how to send out list emails and mass emails in Salesforce. All right, we're first gonna show you how to send a mass email. Now, if you're in Lightning and you're not in Classic anymore, skip to the list email section of this video. Don't recommend you learning how to send mass emails from Classic. Now we're gonna go to our Contacts tab and we're going to click Mass Email Contacts. If you don't see that link, that means you don't have the permission to send mass emails in Salesforce and you'll need to ask your admin for that permission. We're gonna go ahead and create a new view here. And this is going to be my customers for my TMPAA invite. And I'm going to filter on only the people who have an account status of customer. We have a dropdown on our account record called status, and this is how we identify our customers versus our prospects. I'm also going to further limit who comes into here because I have a limit in my developer org that only allows me to email 10 people via mass email. So I'm going to put a second filter on here that says account name is equal to Walt Disney World. I'm then also going to add a couple of columns to here to make sure that I'm pulling in the people that I want. And then I can also put in contact status too. We have a contact status field that tells us what the status of the contact is with their particular company. Once you get all the filters set for who you want to target, you can click save. And then I've got two people that are coming into here. They're both active, which is awesome. And I'm going to uncheck Minnie and just check Mickey. So you, however many contacts you get into this list, you don't have to select all of them to receive the email. I'm only going to select one of the two people who came in here. Now you do have a limit on mass emails, just so you know. You can only send 5,000 mass or list emails per day. All right, so this next screen is where I choose which email template I want to use. And this is where the folders come in really handy that we learned how to create in our previous video on Lightning email templates and Classic email templates. So if you haven't seen that, go ahead and check it out. Now in here, you can see I don't have the ability to find my Lightning email templates. So mass emails can only be used with Classic email templates. This is the only Classic email template I have in this folder, so I'll select that one. I will click next. And then you can tell it to BCC you on one message. So you're going to get copied on one email that goes out. It just makes you feel better that the email went out. I usually always click that. And then you can name the mass email here. And then you can choose whether or not you want to store an activity for each message. Now, what this means is it's going to create a task record related to the contact in the activity history. I know that we have enhanced email turned on. We turned that on in one of the previous videos when we were learning how to create our templates. Enhanced emails allow us to enable that email message object. One of the cons in sending a mass email is the email is not logged in the email message object. It's logged as a task. So keep in mind, this is old functionality. This is what we used in Classic. List emails is the new functionality, and we highly recommend that you move to using that if you're in Lightning. Now I can choose whether or not I want to send this email now, or if I want to schedule it for delivery at a later point in time. I'm going to go ahead and click send now. And then it tells me that I have completed the email wizard, and I'm going to click finish here. Now, whenever your mass email is done sending, you are going to get a confirmation email that looks like this. And you can click this link. And we can see that the status of it is completed. I was sending it to one person. It was successfully sent to one person. And so everything looks good there. And then I was also copied on one email that went out. So I can see that this is what the email that went to Mickey. This is what it looks like. So everything looks good there. If you want to learn how to create this email template, check out our other video on Classic versus Lightning email templates. Okay, so now let's go to our contact record for Mickey and let's see what happened there. So if I go to my activity history, I can see that this record right here is what was just created to log the fact that that email went out. So you can see that it's a task record. And this is all the information that you get. So if we switch to Lightning, I'm going to go back to Mickey's contact. I'm going to show you a couple of things here. So these emails, these records right here that were have an email message icon, these were sent from Salesforce, from Lightning using this email icon. And we have enhanced email on. So these are email message records. So when we click on them, they look very different than a task record. They have details over here, tells us when they opened it. On this mass email record, we don't really have anything. Not much information here at all. Now, if you're looking for reporting on your mass emails, we'll show you how to create those reports in a future video. Now let's go on to list emails. All right, what we're gonna do is go to our nine dots and we're gonna go to list emails. So list emails are in their own tab. We can see that we don't have any because we haven't sent one. Now you have three options for sending list emails. You can send it from this tab, from the contact tab, or from the lead. So we'll start from here first. And when I click send list email, I can see that I don't have any recipients in here. So if I start typing in here, I can see that my campaigns come up. So if you're using the send list email button from the list email tab, you can only send to a campaign. So if we create a campaign here, oops, that's the wrong field. Let's put it here. And then I have a lot of required fields, which you should too. The date of this email should be the date that it's going out. The start and end date of the campaign. And then I'm going to add Mickey. Now I'm going to come back to my list email tab. I'm going to click send list email. I'm going to put in 2024 TMPAA. And there's my campaign. And then I can choose my email template. So we can see here in list emails, I can choose either a classic or a lightning email template because these are the two templates I created in the previous video. So I'm going to go ahead and use my lightning email template, and I can see the field merges come in and the body of the email come in. Now I can click review and I can see what it's going to look like for Mickey. I can come back here and I can change the email template to maybe my classic one. It'll overwrite everything for me, make it center justified. You know, if you watched a previous video, you know I hate that. And here's what the email template will look like as an example. Now you can choose to send this now or later. If you send later, it'll ask you for a time to send it. I'm gonna go ahead and send this now. Now you can see that it writes a record in your list email tab. It shows you what the email looks like. And then over here, it's going to quantify how many were sent out and then the status of that list email. Now you can see down here, it's going to show you exactly the email that went out. Then you also get a confirmation email sent to your email inbox that looks like this. It has a link that you can click just like you could for the mass email. So I'll go ahead and go to that. And you can see that that's just the link to the list email record that we are on over here. Okay, now we're going to go back to Mickey's contact and we're going to see what it looked like over there. I want to go in lightning. We can see how different everything looks, right? So this is what a list email looks like. If we click into this, we can see we don't get to see the field merges get populated with the contact's information, which is unfortunate. We see our email template exactly how it looked. If we go to details, we don't see any other information here either. We just see the status and the total sent. So this is basically the same information that we saw on the list email record. Now let's show you how to send a list email from a contact list. So we'll go to our contacts tab, and then I'm going to go to my all contacts tab and I'm going to clone this. And this is going to be my customers for TMPAA. And then I'm going to add some filters here. I only want the people who have a status of customer or previous customer. And then maybe I only want the people who have a contact status of active. And if you don't have these status fields on your accounts and contacts, go check out one of our contact management videos. We show you the recommendations that we follow whenever we're managing contacts within Salesforce. And it really helps us be able to filter these lists quickly and efficiently whenever we have conferences or trade shows or email communications that we want to send out. So now I have a list of 10 people. So I can say, maybe I want to send this email to only these 7 people. So you're going to check the boxes of the people you want to send, and then you can click send list email. And then you can see it says 7 recipients from that email. And then I can select my email template, whichever one it is you want to use. I can click review and I can see that it's going to go to all these people. And here's what this email template looks like for Avi. You'll click send and then you'll get a success message. And that's it. That's how you send a list email from your contact tab. Leads work the exact same way. You can just create a list and filter from there. You don't even have to create a new list either. So if you're on your recently viewed list, and there's a couple of people that you want to email from here, you can check the boxes right from this list, any list that you can see, click send list email, and then your 5 people go right in there. And then you just choose the appropriate template. All right, so that's how you send your list emails or your mass emails. List emails, definitely better functionality. And if you're looking for ideas on how to report on all of this email activity, check out the next video. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blu Tiger Academy so you don't miss the next video we are working on that will show you how to report on the emails you are sending out of Salesforce. There are different types of reports you need to set up depending how the email was sent. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you would like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.